Hi friends, this is the lecture number 5, statistics part 1. So today we will discuss on the quartiles, deciles and percentile. What is the difference between this? Okay, why the scientists they use such type of words in statistics? Okay, so before coming in this lecture, my request to everyone that go in the previous lecture. Okay, then this concept it will be clear. Because all the lectures, these are linked together. Okay, these lectures are very important for research holder, PhD holder. Okay, already we have discussed for BTech student. So now there are three types of data. At first, you must open a copy. Whatever we are teaching, you must note. That will be better for you to understand. Okay. So now you can see that here we have collected the data, and but we have shifted the frequency. In this first, this is the serial number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. In the first, the frequency is 6, 4, 2, the frequency is 4, 4, 3, the frequency is 7, 4, 4, the frequency is 3, and 4, 5, the frequency is 2. The cumulative frequency is 6, 6 plus 4 is equal to 10, 10 plus 7 is equal to 17, 17 plus 3 is equal to 20, 20 plus 2 is equal to 22. Okay. If going the previous lecture, the median, how to find the median? Total data are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are odd. Whenever the data are odd, then you will use this formula, n upon 2. What is n? N is the sum of all frequencies. The sum of all frequencies, that is 22, already we have done. So 22 upon 2 is equal to 11. So 11, this data in the cumulative frequency, this 17, it is holding 11. Okay. So 11 is inside in this 17. It means that your median, it will be 3. In this condition, your median, it will be 3. Okay. Now, same data we have taken here, the same data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, but we have shifted, we have changed the frequency, we have shifted the frequency, not changing. So, these are all the data are same, 6, 4, 7, 3, 2, okay, we have shifted it. So, 4, 1, the data is 7, 4, 2, the frequency is 6, 4, 3, the frequency is 2, and 4, 4, the frequency is 3, 4, 5, the frequency is 4. Now the cumulative frequency is 7, 7 plus 6 is equal to 13, 13 plus 2 is equal to 15, 15 plus 3 is equal to 18, and 18 plus 4 is equal to 22. Now again we are finding the median. Median is equal to this, sum of all the frequency upon 2. So 22 upon 2 is equal to 11. Okay. So this 13, it is holding 11. Okay. So it means that your median is time 2. Okay. Now third time, again we have shifted and rearranged the data. We have arranged the data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First data is 4, frequency is 4, then 4, 2, the frequency is 2, 4, 3, the frequency is 4, 4, 4, the frequency is 6, and 4, 5, the frequency is 7. Okay, the cumulative frequency is 4, 4 plus 2 is equal to 6, 6 plus 3 is equal to 9, and 9 plus 6 is equal to 15, and 15 plus 7 is equal to 22. Now the median is equal to 22 upon 2 is equal to 11. This data it is holding 11, so your median is 4. Now you can see that for the same data, the median is changing. Here your median is 3, here your median is 2, but here your median is 4. Okay, so this is a this is 11, here also this is 11, here also this is 11. But your median will be changing for same data. So there is a problem. So we cannot observe by the help of median, by the help of this 11 and 11. Okay. We cannot observe any idea about the data. So after them, the scientist, what they have done? They have divided the data in many parts. Okay. In this condition, we are not finding any conclusion about the data. In this condition, you can see we are not finding any conclusion about the data. We cannot find any idea about the data. So to get the better idea, so the scientists, what they have done, they have divided the data. Okay, so at first we will explain about the quartiles. Now the partitions, partitions means you are dividing it. Okay, now the partitions of data, these are the values which divide the series into a number of parts, equal parts, but parts must be equal. Okay, equal parts, the 3 points which divide the series into 4 equal parts are called quartiles. You can see that here we have divided it in 4 parts. Okay, 1 part, 2nd part, 3rd part, 4th part, all parts are equal. Okay, whenever you will divide the data, whenever you will divide the data in 4 equal parts, that is called quartiles. This is the definition of quartiles. So why we are dividing? To get the better result, to get the better conclusion. Okay, so this is 25%, this is also 25%, this is also 25%, this is also 25%. Okay, so now the first, second and third, these are the name are first, second and third quartiles. Okay, now if you will divide, suppose we are not getting conclusion in this condition, suppose you have a very big data, so in this condition you have divided the 9 points which divide the series into 10 equal parts. If you will divide 10 equal parts, then this is called deciles. Okay, if you will divide the series in 10 equal parts, that is called deciles. Why we are doing it? To get a better idea. Okay, now if suppose you have a big data, just you have seen, if you have given the GR exam, if you have given the GATE exam, so the government, they are providing your scorecard. You have seen in your scorecard, they are giving you percentile. In IITJ exam also, they are giving you scorecard and they have written the percentile. What is the meaning of percentile? Percentile means, suppose you have 99 percentile, it means that 99% people are left, they are behind you. 99% students are behind you. Percentile does not mean you have 99%. Percentage is different. Means percentage means out of 100 you have got 99 marks. But if you have 99 percentile, it means that 99% people are behind you. Maybe suppose there is an exam and the exam is very tough, and out of 100 if you have got 50 marks, suppose, and you are the first, your rank is first, so your percentile, it will be 100. It means that 100% people are behind you. Okay, no one is above than you. Okay, if suppose you have 99, suppose you have 48 marks in this, and you are the second candidate, and maybe many students, they can get 48 marks, it can possible. Suppose total 10,000 or 1 lakh people, they have given the exam, and suppose 1,000 people, they have got 48 marks, okay, out of 100, and these all 100 students, they have got second rank. You must think, they have got second rank. So there is a formula, by the help of this formula, we are finding it. So the 99% people behind you. Okay, so the meaning of percentile is different, meaning of percentage is different. Meaning of percentage is you have got 99 marks, and percentile means these total number of 99% people behind you. Okay, so never think that if you have 99 percentile, it means that you have got 99% in your exam. Maybe you have got 40 marks out of 100, it can possible. It's depend on the exam. So in the percentile are the 99 points which divide the series into 100 equal parts. If you have big data in this condition, you know that if you are giving the exam, the GATE exam, in the GATE exam many people, 13 lakh or 17 lakh people they are giving. In the GRE exam more than 40 or 50 lakh people they are giving the exam. In this condition they have used the percentile. The percentile are the 99 points which divide the series into 100 equal parts. Okay, which divide the series into 100 equal parts, Okay, so this is the meaning of this. Now we will solve one example. If you will solve this example, then you will get how to use it. Okay, so the question is, example, 8 coins were tossed together and the number of heads, you must write in your copy. Okay, it will be better. 8 coins were tossed together and the number of heads resulting was rotated. The operation was repeated 256 times. Okay, and the frequencies f that were obtained for the different values of x, the number of heads are shown in the following table. This table. Calculate the median, quartiles, deciles, percentiles, they are asking. But they have asked the quartiles, median, 4th decile, the 27th decile. I have seen many students, they do not have clear the idea about this. Suppose I am writing 1 upon 2, what is the meaning? So what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of 1 upon 2? Okay, if you have a rod, okay, you have a rod, okay, so you have divided the rod in 2 parts. You have divided the rod in 2 parts, okay. So one part it is indicating this 1 upon 2. One part it is indicating 1 upon 2. Suppose in place of this, suppose I am writing 3 upon 4. You have a rod, okay. And there are total number of 4 parts. And 3 parts, these 3 parts, it is indicating 3 upon 4. So this is the meaning of 3 upon 4, this is the meaning of 1 upon 2. Okay, so similarly, in this question it will be understood by the help of this method. You have divided the data in many parts. Okay, so it will be understood what is the meaning of Q1, what is the meaning of Q3, what is the meaning of D4, what is the meaning of 27. So you have divided the data, this is the we have written D4. At first we will explain this one, Q1. So you have divided the data in 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have divided the data in 4 equal parts. 1 upon 4 means we are asking about this. And if he has written 3 upon 4, we are asking about this. 3 upon 4 means this. I think that you understand. Okay. So the meaning of, at first you have to understand the word, what is the meaning of the fraction 1 upon 4, 3 upon 4, 4 by 10. You have divided the data in 10 equal parts and the 4 parts are D4. You have divided the data in 100 equal parts. The 27th part, total number of 27 part among 100 is indicating 27 upon 100. This is the meaning of this. So at first we have understood the meaning of fraction. Now we are coming in this question. So he is asking the median, quartiles, deciles and percentiles. So at first we will find the median. Whenever we have given the data, at first you will count how many data are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Total data are 9. It means the data are odd. Whenever the data is odd, then you will use the formula n upon 2. The sum of the number. Okay. The sum of the number, that is 2, 5, 6. The sum of the number is 2, 5, 6. So 2, 5, 6 upon 2 is equal to 128. This is your median. N is equal to, this is your median, 128. Okay. So the second question is asking quartiles. Okay. So quartiles, you have to find Q1. You have to find Q1. Q1 means 1 upon 4 n. Quartile means you have divided the data in 4 equal parts and he is asking the 1 part among 4 part. So means 1 upon 4 n. N is 256. So 256 upon 4 is equal to 64. Okay. So now how to check what is the median? So whatever we got 128 here above. So cumulative frequency just greater than 128. So is 167. What is the meaning of this? 128, this 167, it is holding 128. This 167, it is holding 128. So the value, now you will check the value, that is 4. So your median is 4. This is your median, okay? This is not your median 128. Your median is 4, okay? So now in Q1, your 1 upon 4 already we have explained. So you have got 64, and your cumulative frequency is just greater than 64 is 95. Means this 64, this 95, it is holding 64. You can see before the data is 36. Before the data is 36, but the data is 95. It means that 95 it is holding 64, because 64 it is greater than 36. So your this Q1, your Q1 is 3. Your Q1 is 3. Okay. So now Q3. What about Q3? Q3 means you have divided the data 4 equal parts, and he is asking the third part, total number of 3 parts. So this is 3 upon 4. So 3 upon 4, n means 256. So 256 into 3 upon 4, that is 192. 192, the cumulative frequency just greater than 192. 192 means 219. Okay, because 167, that is less than 192. It means that 192, this 192, this 219, it is holding 192. Okay, it means that your cumulative frequency is just greater than 2. This is 219. It means that your Q3, it will be 5. In front of this, your Q3 is equal to 5. I think that you understand. Okay, if you do not understand, again we will explain. D4. If you have to find D4, D4 means you have divided data in 10 equal parts, and he is asking the fourth part. Okay, so 4 upon 10, n means 256. So 4 into 256 upon 10 is 102 upon 4. So you will check what data it is holding, 102.4. So now you can see this 95, it is less than 102. So 167, it is greater than 102. It means that 167, it is holding 102.4. Okay, because why we are just saying that it is holding? Because 1 is equal to 1, 1 plus 9 is equal to 10. It means that inside 10, there is a 9. 10 plus 26 is equal to 36. It means that inside 36, all the values means 1 also, 2 also, 3 also, 35 also, inside this value. Okay. So 4 upon 10, n is equal to 102. So this is 167. So 16 in front of 167 is 4. So your D4 is equal to 4. Okay. P27. P27 means you have divided the data in 100 equal parts, and he is asking the 27th part. So 27 upon 100 into n is equal to 256. So 256 into 27 upon 100 is equal to 69.12. So now you will check what the data it is. This is holding this 69.12. Now you can see that 36 is less than this, and 95, this is greater than 69. It means that this 95, it is holding this one. It means that your P27, percentile 27 is 3. Okay, your percentile 27 is 3. Okay, I think that you understand the meaning of fraction, the meaning of quartiles, the meaning of percentiles, the meaning of deciles. We have explained everything. So this is the part number 1 for the lecture 5. Now the question is, If you have intervals 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 10 to 30, suppose such type of questions, how to solve such type of questions? Such questions they have also asked in your university exam. So we will solve one question that will be very important for you, because such questions are coming in your, I have seen many times such questions are coming in the competitive exam, also in your university exam. Okay, so you must go in the part number 2. Thank you so much.